Hello, welcome to session 10 of Fetal Growth and Child Development. In this session, we are going to look at breastfeeding, which is very, very important. Overview: breast milk is produced naturally by women and provides basic nutrients for a baby during the first 7 months of life. WHO recommends exclusive breastfeeding for the first 6 months of life as the best food for optimal growth. We'll look at definition of breastfeeding, types of breastfeeding, mechanism of lactation, types of breast milk, and the component of breast milk. This is the reading list. Definition of breastfeeding. Breastfeeding is a process by which human milk is given to the infant. Breastfeeding is the most effective way to provide a baby with a caring environment and complete food. It also meets the nutritional as well as emotional and psychological needs of the infant. We have types of breastfeeding. The four breastfeeding, according to WHO, is exclusive breastfeeding, and this type of feeding, no liquid or solid from any other source enters the baby's mouth. Almost exclusive breastfeeding, occasionally taste of liquids, traditional preparation, vitamins and medicines are allowed. Then we also have full breast milk feeding. In this type of feeding, infants receive expressed milk in addition to breastfeeding. Exclusive breastfeeding means feeding a baby solely on breast milk for 6 months. No drink nor food may be added. So this is the definition that we are using in Ghana. Look at the mechanism of lactation. Milk production and secretion are responsive to two major hormones. That's the prolactin and oxytocin. And in addition, we have the suckling reflex. So after production of the milk in the alveolus, the milk moves to the ducts and are stored in the latiferal sinuses. When the infant latches on the breast, milk is expressed from the sinuses. Still on the mechanism, the suckling of the breast by the infant stimulates the nipple. So when the infant latches on the breast and suckles, it stimulates the nipple, then send messages to the spinal cord as well as the brain. Then prolactin is released from the anterior pituitary gland for milk production. The suckling of the breast increases prolactin level. At each feeding, level rises and hence more milk production. We have types of breast milk. The colostrum or the early milk is produced in the last stage of pregnancy until about 4 days after delivery. Transitional milk is produced from 4th to 10th day and is lower in protein in comparison to the colostrum. Then we have the matured milk. The matured milk is produced from approximately 10 days after delivery until termination of the breastfeeding. Even for the mature milk, we have types. We have the full milk and we have the hind milk. The full milk, it comes at the beginning of the feed and is usually watery and gray. The hind milk looks whiter than the full milk because it contains more fat. Look at the composition of breast milk. We have the colostrum. The colostrum contains immunoglobulin, it contains more lactoferrin, it has more sodium and zinc, it has more white blood cells, and it contains less fat and lactose. The composition of mature breast milk, about 90% is water, as it contains most suitable protein, calcium in the right proportion. It contains the right amount of fat. It contains more lactose, that's milk sugar, than most other milk. We are still on the composition of mature breast milk. It contains enough iron, which is better absorbed. Babies that are breastfed don't usually get anemia. They have correct amount of salt, calcium, and phosphate. It contains special enzyme lipase, which digests the fats and anti-infective factors which prevent infections. It contains immunoglobulin, which protects the babies until they can produce their own antibodies. Techniques of breastfeeding. The babies should be properly positioned to achieve effective latching. The mother should wear comfortable apparel with the breast well exposed. The infant's mouth, chin, and umbilicals should be in line with the head and in neutral positions. The infant is brought to the breast with the nose touching or close to the breast. The gum line should overlap the areola and the nipple straight back into the mouth. And the tongue moves forward and beyond the lower gum, curved and forming a reservoir. Thank you. So we've been looking at breastfeeding. We have looked at the physiology of breastfeeding. We have looked at the composition of the breast milk and techniques used during breastfeeding. Thank you.